being focused? That is also a question. Let's hope so. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I currently have tea in my hand and it's really hot and it's burning me. So today I thought that I would do a like chatty video because as you all know, like from my previous videos, I feel like I've just gone on about it for the past like year. I've just come to university, I've just finished my like third official week. Like I moved in 3 weeks ago today, but it was like my second like academic week, like timetabled week. And I just thought that I would sit down, have a chat. I've got a few like things that I wanted to just talk about, like freshers week and my experience with freshers, because that was what I expected, and just general life update, to be honest. I thought it'd be nice to sit down and have a cup of tea with you guys, and I hope that you have tea too, because you know, tea makes everything better. So we'll start off with freshers. Now, obviously, like you come to university and everyone knows there's someone in their underwear. Such a child. Like, basically, there's another block of apartments like opposite me, and there's someone who's clearly forgotten to close their windows. Anyway, freshers week. Everyone comes to university, and I feel like first years, especially freshers, like obviously freshers is targeted at them to make friends, but there's also, I think, over the years it's developed into a big like drinking thing. So like you drink every day, and it originally used to be a week, but our one was actually 2 weeks, so it actually ended last week. And 2 weeks of drinking, anyone who went out every night, like how? I'm just completely baffled as to, one, how can you afford it on a student budget? Like my student loan doesn't even cover my housing, let alone like going out every night. And two, how can you hack it? Like literally after two nights out, I was ill and tired and grumpy. So I came to freshers thinking that I would probably be out every night for freshers week, because I just thought it was 1 week. But I actually wasn't. I took myself by surprise, and I feel like my friends at home would be very disappointed at me, because they know that when I go out, you know, I party hard. Do you mind? Me and my best friend Soph, when we go out especially, like we have a proper good night out, and I thought that I'll be out every night, drinking every night and enjoying myself. I'm not saying I didn't enjoy freshers, but that's not what happened. So basically I arrived on the Saturday, I went out on the Saturday to O2 Academy, and I also went out on the Sunday to a club called Athena. And these were obviously the first freshers events, so they were very busy, but it was sort of a bit like everyone was sort of finding their feet, and it was a bit like, I don't know, they weren't great because they were the first events, and I think that just sort of put me in a frame of mind where I just thought that the rest of the freshers week was going to be like that, which I know was the wrong frame of mind. So I went out on the Saturday and the Sunday, and on the Sunday one of my friends got very drunk, and we came home early, but we ended up staying up until like 4 in the morning at someone else's flat. So anyway, they were the first two nights, and they were the nights that I would say I probably made the most friends, because I was out, and like they're the people that I'm friends with now, basically. And then for the rest of the week, basically I didn't go out on the Monday or Tuesday, and then I had intended to go out on Wednesday, but on Tuesday, like freshers flu hit me hard. Like the second day of freshers, or like third day of freshers, I was ill, like I couldn't breathe properly, my asthma was really bad, and I was like full of cold, it was gross, I was so snotty. And I just like, I feel like when I'm ill particularly, because I don't often get ill, like I haven't been ill all year, and then as soon as I move away I get ill, and I just didn't want to go out, like that didn't appeal to me, going out. So for the rest of the 3 days of like the beginning of freshers, so Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, I didn't go out, and I actually felt, I don't know, I didn't feel like I was missing out, but I felt like because there was so much stigma around freshers that I should be going out. But I'm glad that I didn't, because like personal choice, I had so much sleep those 3 days, and then I woke up feeling so much better. And then I did go out for like the rest of, not, I went out a few times over the like remaining week and a half. I probably went out about 3 times. And I'm glad that I only went out 3 times, because I think had I gone out more, one, I'd probably be broke AF right now, and two, I would also be very tired. But another thing is, so I'm not a massive drinker, I've discovered, like freshers has taught me that. So I went out for the 3 nights, and then for some of the other nights I just went around to like friends' flats, and they were having drinks, and I wouldn't drink. And people would look at me so weirdly when I would be like, I don't really want to drink, because drinking, I'm quite a small person, so I get very drunk very quickly, like, I won't lie. So that's why I choose not to drink, and also it messes with my training, like, I'd rather get up what, do you mind? I would rather get up and go for a run than wake up hungover, basically. And this to freshers, see, this is what I mean when there's a lot of stigma around drinking, because this idea to freshers was like unheard of. Like, people would look at me so weirdly, like, why are you here when you're not even drinking, kind of thing. And it made me feel so awkward, but I'm so glad that I like stuck to my guns and didn't drink, because I think had I drunk, then I would have given into it and I would have like low-key hated myself for it. But I stuck to my guns and didn't drink. But freshers just wasn't what I expected, like, at all. It was a good couple of weeks, but I feel like it wasn't like going out drinking, partying every night like I had anticipated. But needless to say, like, I still had a fab time and I made so many good friends, and it did help me settle in a lot. Like, it really did help me settle in, because I think then making friends helped with homesickness and things, which is something I'm going to get onto next. Right, so that was my like freshers experience very briefly, and I think everyone should do freshers at some point in their life. It's like character building. And another topic that I wanted to talk about was homesickness, because I'm very much a homebody, and moving away from like my family, I was worried that I was going to be very homesick. But I haven't been too bad, or I've been like a bit bad, but nowhere near as bad as I thought I was going to be. So homesickness didn't really hit me until the Thursday of freshers, so I've been here nearly a week. And I think that was literally just because I was ill and tired, and all of these emotions, like, they just, it suddenly hits you, and being ill just heightened all the emotions. And I won't lie, I did sit here and have a little cry on the phone to my dad, but my dad knows exactly what to say, and he made me feel better about it. And like, everyone's in the same boat, and I think that's what I needed to realise, was that I wasn't the only one that was like homesick. If you've watched my like dealing with anxiety video, you will know that over the past year my mental health has been like, it's been a struggle for me, and I was worried that coming to university would like flick that switch and it would become bad again. But I think where I've like kept myself busy, and I've made so many new friends, I've literally like thrown myself into everything, it's been okay. Like, granted, I've had days where I have felt quite anxious, and that's led me to feel quite homesick, and I've had a little cry, but then I've like found ways to combat it. So I just go for a run, or I'll go around to Tash and Em's flat, or like, there's ways of dealing with it now. But homesickness is something that I thought would be a lot worse than what it has been. So yeah, like I say, Thursday was the first day that I was really homesick, and I did cry a lot. And then the other time that I was quite homesick was actually last Sunday, and that was again because I was very tired, because I went out on Saturday, because that was the closing freshers party, and I had a great time. Also, I saw from the videos, I can't tell you really what happened, but it was a good night, and I didn't get a lot of sleep like the Saturday night, Sunday morning, just where I was like out late and stuff and up late. So then on the Sunday morning, I woke up feeling very anxious and very homesick. And I think it just sort of made me realise, like, that's another reason not to drink loads, because I will wake up feeling really, even if I'm not hungover the next day, I just wake up feeling really like anxious, and like, it's a weird feeling, I don't really know how to explain it. But homesickness hasn't been as big of a problem as I thought it would be. Obviously, I miss my family, I miss my mum and dad, I miss my brothers and my dog, and like everyone back home, and Soph, I miss Soph. But I think where I've been enjoying myself so much, and like keeping myself so busy and making new friends, it's sort of something that I don't like. I try not to think about it, and by keeping myself busy, that helps. Homesickness is like something that everyone experiences, regardless of whether you say, oh no, I don't get homesick, I don't miss home at all. You will, like, you will miss home. But just throw yourself into everything. If that's one piece of advice I could give anyone for like next year, is to just throw yourself into everything, like societies, like days out, going to, like, just get yourself out there, because that's the way that you're going to make friends. Your friends are going to be the people that you're going to be spending all your time with. They sort of become your like family. Like, it's weird, I'm living with people who I didn't know 3 weeks ago, but I feel like I've known them for so long now, and like I've made friends in the same like respect. I've only known them a couple of weeks, but I feel like I've known them for a really long time, and that makes me feel quite at home. So by throwing myself into everything, that's just really helped. And then the one last thing that I kind of wanted to talk about as well, just to catch you all up on it, is my workload. So obviously I'm on an art and design course, which means my course is very coursework heavy. I thought that so far I haven't had like tons and tons of work, but in the next couple of weeks, because my deadline's at the beginning of November, I know that I'm gonna have a lot more work. But so far I've been managing it, and being able to manage sort of like, well, actually the first week I struggled with balancing like my social life, blogging, YouTube, and lectures and coursework and things like that, and it was really hard to sort of get into a routine where I was making sure I left enough time for everything. But sort of like last week I was sort of getting there, and now this week I found a way to make sure like I get everything done and I leave enough time for having a social life and blogging and YouTube alongside my studies, because obviously my studies are the most important thing. My workload, I have been able to deal with it so far, but I'm pretty sure it's about to get a lot more, like a lot work heavy, and that scares me a little bit because I'm a very stressy person, like I get very stressed out very easily. So I'm about to get very stressed, and the people in my course are gonna see me cry at some point soon, I bet. I know that's really not the way to think of it, like don't think that I'm gonna be stressed, but I just know I will. And I'm one of them people that I need quite a bit of reassurance that like I'm doing well and like I'm going in the right direction. And my college tutor warned me of this, that I wouldn't have that because university lecturers don't have time for that. And although like I'd been told this like prior to coming to university, it still has taken me by shock a bit, and I'm having to be much more independent with my studies, which I have struggled with, I won't lie. Like I've really struggled with like judging whether what I'm doing is right or wrong. Like there is no right and wrong in art, like I'm not saying that there is, but I feel like I just need that little bit of reassurance that what I'm doing is good and what I'm doing is okay, and I haven't had that, and I think that is what has been the biggest struggle for me, is not having that. But yeah, that's the one thing that I've struggled with, is being much more independent in my studies. It's like a step up from college, where I was quite independent anyway, but I had my college lecturers there to sort of like guide me in the right direction and help me with ideas. And at university, you have it, but you don't have it so much, like it's not so like readily available because they have very busy schedules. So yeah, that's what I have struggled with. But overall, the first few weeks of university have been really good. I've enjoyed them, I've made lots of good memories and lots of good friends, and I'm just sort of taking every day as it comes at the minute. It makes me feel a little bit less stressed, so I'm just taking it as it comes and enjoying my time here. And I can't believe I've been here 3 weeks as I'm filming this, like that is mad. I can't even get my head around it. And 3 weeks today, my parents are coming up. Woo! Actually, when this goes up, it'll be like 2 weeks today my parents will be coming up. So they're coming up to visit me for the weekend, and I kid you not, I'm so excited. One, because you know, I get to my parents, but two, Mum said that we can go for a roast dinner, and I'm absolutely craving a roast dinner, so I literally cannot wait for when they come up. But yes, I hope you have enjoyed this like chattier video. I might do like one of these a month just to like catch you up on my studies and just sort of like, I think it's nice to look back on my experience at university, and it's nice to sort of tell people like my experience, like how I found it. So if this is something that like you would be interested in seeing more frequently, like maybe once a month or once a fortnight, do let me know in the comments. If you're new to my channel, please click subscribe so you don't miss any future uploads, and make sure you like, comment and all that fun stuff, because you know how much I love reading your comments. And I will see you all in my next video.